السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلي وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. ما بعد، إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، خير الهدي هدي نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، كل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. إن شاء الله this is the second lecture about منهج السلف. The book by Sheikh Abdullah Ubaylan. And this is one of the very important issues, to know your manhaj, to know your manhaj. How many people missed their manhaj and they fell in a big problem in their dunya and also their akhirah. Because of what? Because the issue of manhaj. And this is what makes the Salaf unique, because they have a clear manhaj based on Quran and authentic Sunnah. So we'll continue inshallah the book. We finish how many points? We finish four points, صح? Anyone is following? No one following? Okay, so if you are not following, let's review. What was the first point? Religion is based on two fundamentals. The what? No, not the Quran. The two fundamental principles.
Quran and Sahih Sunnah.
No, this is not first point. The first point we mentioned that ikhlas wal mutaba'ah, sincerity and following. Sincerity and following. For you, for any deed to be accepted, you have to achieve these two points. If there is no sincerity, then it is shirk. If there is no following, then it is bid'ah. طيب. And no, point number two, the source of the sharia, da'wah and worship is taken from Quran and Sahih Sunnah, yes, authentic Sunnah. Okay, and we emphasize this point. صحيح السنة, not any sunnah or not any hadith. The hadith should be authentic. So the source of sharia, da'wah and worship. So this is very important, because maybe you'll find some people and in their worship, okay, they are following the sunnah, but in their da'wah, no. Or in the sharia, only from the Quran and sunnah, but in their worship, no problem. They take from scholars, from dreams, from anything. Your sharia, your ibadah, your da'wah should be from Quran and authentic sunnah. This number two. Number three, we should understand the Quran by the way of the sunnah. By the way of the sunnah. You understand Quran through the sunnah. You don't understand the Quran independently. No. Quran and through the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Number four, we don't understand the Quran and the Sunnah independently from the understanding of the Salaf. So the previous point, not only Quran, it should be Quran through the Sunnah. The next point, number four, Quran and Sunnah through the understanding of the Salaf. The Sahaba, of course, the Sahaba and those who followed the Sahaba, bi ihsan, radiyallahu ta'ala anhum. And this is very important. طيب, let's continue. Today's lecture, number five. القاعدة الخامسة, the fifth principle. أنهم أول ما يدعون إلى التوحيد فلا تنجح دعوة. ها؟ It is not working. تمام الحين؟ تمام؟ تمام سيف؟ اوكي؟ تمام طيب. So الحمد لله sister, you do not miss. We started by reviewing, so now we start the tonight's lecture from point number five. Tanweed, you have the notes? Not, huh?
The book.
Oh, Arabic.
The English one.
Hey. Should be reviewed to the one from John. Because if no notes, no is one is writing, so maybe if you share, good to follow. طيب نمبر 5 انهم اول ما يدعون الى التوحيد فلا تنجح دعوه ولا تصلح عباده الا به. The first thing in دعوه is توحيد. This is منهج السلف. You start with توحيد. From where? This is from Quran and the Sunnah, from the seerah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And this is one of the points telling you the importance of learning the seerah, the biography of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You will find him, he started with tawheed, with the aqidah. He started with one, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ قُولُوا لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ تُفْلِحُوا. All people say لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ, you'll succeed. طيب, success will be achieved when you say لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ. What does it mean لَا إِلَهَ اللَّهُ here? It means aqidah, he started with aqidah. He did not start with Abu Jahl, don't kill your daughter. He did not tell his uncle Abbas, don't take riba. He started with tawheed. So the first thing in da'wah is tawheed. No da'wah or worship will be successful without tawheed. For sure. If there is a lajna, if there is a da'iyah, if there is a group, they are involved in da'wah, but they are not starting with tawheed, fail, خلاص. Fail, no success. Maybe they will achieve nice things, but this is not according to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants. And there are proofs for that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Anbiya, ayah number 25, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِكَ مِنْ رَسُولٍ إِلَّا نُوحِي إِلَيْهِ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنَا فَعْبُدُونَ. And we send not before you any messenger except that we reveal to him that لا إله إلا أنا فاعبدون. توحيد. فاعبدون. Worship me alone. Another ayah. ولقد أوحي إليك وإلى الذين من قبلك لئن أشركت ليحبطن عملك. لئن أشركت. And it was already revealed to you. What does it mean here? You. محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. And to those before you, that if you should associate anything with Allah, your work would surely become worthless. لَيَحْبَطَنْ عَمَلُكْ. The mountains of hasanat, خلاص, will be nothing. Because of what? Because of shirk. Because of the tawheed is not pure, or there is no tawheed. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Surah An'am, وَلَوْ أَشْرَكُوا لَحَابِطَ عَنْهُمْ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. If they do shirk, everything will be worthless from their acts of worship. خلاص. Because no tawheed, there is shirk. Jazakallah khair. And the famous hadith, Mu'ad. This is very important hadith. I hope that brothers and sisters, you memorize this hadith. Or to be familiar with this hadith. Because you need this hadith in your da'wah, in your life. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sent Mu'ad to Yemen, he said, فَلْيَكُنْ أَوَّلْ مَا تَدْعُوهُمْ إِلَيْهِ أَنْ يُوَحِّدُ اللَّهِ. You are going to some people among the people of the book. إِنَّكَ تَأْتِي قَوْمًا أَهْلَ كِتَابٍ. And what do the scholars say here? As if the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم telling this introduction. As if the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم telling Mu'ad, be careful, you are going to people not like Quraysh. No, they have book. And they have knowledge. So it is not easy to give them da'wah. There will be a discussion. Ahl al-Kitab. Then he said, call them to bear witness. La ilaha illallah. فَلْيَكُنْ أَوَّلْ مَا تَدْعُوهُمْ إِلَيْهِ. Let the first thing that you start with is أَنْ يُوَحِّدُ اللَّهِ. فَلْيَكُنْ أَوَّلْ مَا تَدْعُوهُمْ إِلَيْهِ أَنْ يُوَحِّدُ اللَّهِ. This is the narration of Bukhari. أن يوحدوا الله. طيب فإنهم أطاعوك لذلك فأخبرهم أن الله افترض عليهم 5 صلوات. If they obey you, if they follow you, if they submit for that, then you tell them that Allah obliged them to
pray the five prayers. What do you notice here? فَإِنْهُمْ أَطَاعُوكَ لِذَلِكَ. If they obey you, if they submit. Which means, don't go to the next step until you are sure about the first step. Which means priority. And this is a very important point, brothers and sisters. I have a non-Muslim person. I discuss with him the Islamic finance. I discuss with him the riba. Habibi, tawheed. You start with tawheed. Speak about the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the lordship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the names and the tawheed al-ibadah, to worship him alone subhanahu wa ta'ala. You speak about the shirk, if he's magic, fortune teller. You speak about the main thing, the tawheed. طيب. So this was the message the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam sent Mu'ad to Yemen. And there is a hadith, he mentioned the author here. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala, يعني look, he said the author, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam started with tawheed, lived with tawheed, and end his life with tawheed. The start, the life, and the end. Tawheed, tawheed, tawheed. This doesn't mean I speak only about tawheed, no. But the priority of tawheed, and tawheed should be with me all the time. Because you know, sometimes people say, Habib, let's talk about the seerah, let's talk about the akhlaq, let's talk about the parenting, and let's talk about the children. Okay? خلاص, people will not come. They know, you know, when you do a course about tawheed, already we know also tawheed, already we know aqidah wasitiyah. What is the importance of that? I'm struggling with my children. I want something about the Islamic finance. Also, when we did something about Islamic finance, people did not come last week. Subhanallah. Okay, the Sheikh, mashallah, يعني, he's well experienced. He's in the Sharia committee of AUB, not Kuwait branch. And you know, now AUB is خلاص, KFH, but he is in AUB of Bahrain and Libya. So he's in the field. He's in the field. Subhanallah, يعني, many brothers missed this opportunity. طيب. So Aisha radiallahu ta'ala said, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sick at the end of his life, he was sick, the sickness of death, yeah, before his death in a few days. طافيق يطرح خميصة على وجهه. خميصة, piece of cloth. With water, it was wet with water. Why? Because of the fever. If you have fever, what do? You put something to reduce the temperature. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his temperature was double. Yeah, for example, if our fever, يعني, maximum it is 41, 42, no, his fever may be 45. Too hot, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Too high. So he was keeping the khamis on his face. Imagine, wet piece of cloth on your face. What will happen? Okay, you cannot breathe normally. So he was keeping the khamis, maybe 1 minute, removing that 1 minute. Keeping 1 minute. So he was struggling, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, suffering. Why that? What did he say? He said, La'natullahi ala al-Yahudi wa al-Nasa. May Allah curse Jews and Christians. May Allah curse Jews and Christians. So he cursed them. Yes, he cursed them. And they are not our brothers. They are not our brothers. What is the point when I say no, they are our brothers? Habibi, don't say they are our brothers. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam cursed them. He cursed them, and also this doesn't mean we kill them and we fight them always, all of them. No, we give them da'wah, fighting. There are rules for fighting. But to attract them or to gain them or to give them da'wah, don't say you are our brothers. No. طيب. He said, may Allah curse Jews and Christians. Why? اتخذوا قبور أنبيائهم مساجد. They make the graves of their prophets مساجد. Subhanallah. And unfortunately, many Muslims did that. And they are doing that. Many Muslims. Okay? They do sujood and the graves inside the masjid or at the back of the masjid and doing tawaf on the grave. Subhanallah. This is aqeedah. This is aqeedah. And all the prophets alayhi salatu wasalam doing the same thing or calling the same way. Why? Because he said sallallahu alayhi wasallam al-anbiya ukhwa li'allat. The prophets alayhi salatu wasalam, they are brother, they are ikhwa li'allat. What does mean ikhwa li'allat? The brothers from the same father, different mothers. Okay, it is in Arabic, it is ukhwa allat. Dinuna wahid wa ummahatuna shatta. Our religion is one, which means our aqidah is one. Wa ummahatuna shatta, the mothers are different, which means the sharia different. Aqidah is one, Allah is one. We should worship Allah alone. And the end of the believers, paradise. The end of the disbelievers, hellfire. So the same aqidah, the six pillars of faith, the same. But when you come to the sharia, salah, zakah, hajj, siyam, different. Different. Yeah, for example, the Yahud, they pray, but they don't have ameen in their prayer. We say ameen. They don't give salam. We give salam in our salah. So the sharia is different. They mention in sharia of Yaqub, alayhi salam, it was allowed to marry the two sisters, but in Islam, no, it is not allowed. So this is sharia. And there is no problem. Any problem to different sharia? No problem. Yes, in sharia, there are, of course, there are major things like the adultery is haram, thefting is haram. Of course, we all, the sharia agrees. But there are details different. طيب. There is a saying by one of the scholars, Hassan al-Mutwa'i, or al-Mutawwa'i, said, before that, the author said, Tawheed wa ittiba' al-hawa. The Tawheed and following the desire, they are contradicting. They cannot be in one heart. Okay? They are contradicting. Cannot be in one heart. Then he said, Al-Hawa Sanam. The desire is an idol. What does he mean? Because people worship the idol of the desire. From where? This is from the Quran. أَفَرَأَيْتَ مَنِ اتَّخَذَ إِلَاهَهُ هَوَى. Some people worship Uzair. وَقَالَتْ الْيَهُودُ عُزَيْرٌ إِبْنُ اللَّهِ. They worship Uzair, Jews. وقالت النصارى المسيح ابن الله. Christians said عيسى is the son of Allah. And some people, many people worship cows. People worship many things. Right? And there are people worshiping what? The desire. Their desire. They claim we are atheist. We don't believe in a God. Agnostic atheist. No, you are worshiping. There is no one worshiping nothing. For sure, he's worshiping one God or many gods. And the Muslims worship only one God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he is the only true God, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So those who are claiming, wallahi, they are atheists, we don't believe in a God, they are worshiping the hawa, the desire, subhanallah. And he said, he called it like sanam. It is an idol, the idol of desire. Where is this idol? Inside the heart, subhanallah. And the author said here, nice statement. وليس مراد الله سبحانه كسر الأصنام المجسدة وترك الأصنام التي في القلوب بل المراد كسرها من القلب أولا. The issue and the aim is not to destroy the idols, the physical idols, and to ignore the idols of the hearts. He said the priority is to destroy the idol which is inside your heart. He means the desire. So you're like, subhanallah, right now, alhamdulillah, we don't have idols. Alhamdulillah, we are not like Kuffar Quraysh. They have Lat ul-Uzza 360. Around the Kaaba. 360 idols, or during the time of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, many idols. But subhanAllah, when you check with some people, you will discover that there is an idol inside his heart.
The desire, the idol of the desire. Sanam al-hawa. Number six. أنهم يبدؤون دعوتهم بما بدأ الله به ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم فيقدمون ما قدمه الله ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم ويؤخر ما أخره الله ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم بهذا يمكن تحصيل مصالح ودرء المفاسد. We must start our da'wah with what Allah and His Messenger started with and delay what they delayed. This will give us the ability to repel evil, to achieve the maximum benefit and the profit. Like any company, for any company, any school, there is a priority. We should start with this. Then, okay, in the school, the priority for the PE, or you focus on music, or the drawing. No, if we have school, there are the main major subjects: physics, chemistry, Arabic, English. صح؟ Imagine if you have a school and you focus on the you know, the PE and the drawing and whatever these things. And for English, once a week. For Arabic, once a week. For science, once a week. For no one will bring his children to this school. Of course, the kids like to go to that school, but the parents don't agree. صح؟ So we should start like the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Okay, when you go to Umrah or Hajj, on the after the Tawaf, you are going to Safa. He said صلى الله عليه وسلم, أبدأ بما بدأ الله به. I'm starting with what Allah started with. He means صلى الله عليه وسلم, إن الصفا والمروة من شعائر الله. So you start the Sa'i from Safa or Marwa? Safa, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala started with the Safa. أبدأ بما بدأ الله به. So this should be your title. This should be your symbol. أبدأ بما بدأ الله به. طيب. So you start with something and you delay something. And the famous example when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in the 8th year finished or Makkah conquest, فتح مكة. خلاص. Now Makkah is a Muslim country. He removed the Asnam. This is priority. But there is an issue. He delayed that issue. He did not do that. Which is building the Kaaba or completing the Kaaba. The Kaaba is incomplete. The building was incomplete. He did not tell that. He can, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He can do that, but he did not. Why? This is the wisdom and da'wah. This is the way of the Salaf. Not everything now. No. We think, we plan, we check the priority. We should expect what will happen. Of course, I don't know the future, but we should expect. So, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Makkah conquest, immediately he removed the asnam. This is shirk. We removed the asnam. He destroyed them. وَقُلْ جَاءَ الْحَقُّ وَزَهَقَ الْبَاطِلُ. He destroyed them, saying, وَجَاءَ الْحَقُّ وَقُلْ جَاءَ الْحَقُّ وَزَهَقَ الْبَاطِلُ. Truth came and the battle falsehood finished, left, alhamdulillah. Tawheed came and the shirk left, khalas. But the Kaaba is incomplete. He told Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, and subhanAllah, the hadith is authentic, clear hadith, and we studied the hadith from the seerah. But unfortunately, you'll find many Muslims, many da'iyah, many sheikh don't apply this hadith in their da'wah or in their life. لولا أن قومك حدثاء عهد بجاهلية لهدمت الكعبة ولبنيت على قواعد إبراهيم. If you, he said to Aisha, if your people, Quraysh, his people, صح؟ Quraysh, his tribe, صلى الله عليه وسلم, people of Aisha. If, يعني, because they are new Muslims, I will not build the Kaaba. If they are not new Muslims, which means if they are old Muslims, what I'm going to do? I will remove this Kaaba and I will rebuild the Kaaba on the basis of Ibrahim. And also I will keep the door of Kaaba
attached to the ground. Why? Because the door is up. 3-4 steps above the ground. And I will keep two doors. One door to enter, one door to exit. Okay, is it something mandatory like Tawheed? No. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and this is the da'iyah, the wise da'iyah, the wise scholar, okay? يعني as I think Sheikh Taymiyyah or another scholar said, ليس العلم أن تعرف المصلحة من المفسدة. The real knowledge is not to know what is good and what is bad. This is easy. Drinking khamr, bad. Praying, good. Easy. But the issue is, the real knowledge, is when you have two good things, which one is more important? And when you have bad things, which one is worse? This is the wisdom. Okay, يعني, you know, like physics, the equations, when you give straightforward, it will be very easy for the students. But when you bring something a little bit complicated, you make the students to think, you know who is the good student. So يعني, there is a famous issue they mentioned about Sheikh Islam Taymi rahimahullah, some of the bad people drinking. So his friends say, we should stop them. Drinking khamr is haram. He said, no, leave them. Because if you stop them from drinking khamr, they will wake up, then they will kill the Muslims. So let them, because now we are between two things. Bad people drinking, and the other option, to kill the innocent people. Let the bad people to drink. This is the hikmah, wisdom. But it needs, of course, no, it needs knowledge. Because how can you know? And you estimate this is good and this is worse. Sorry, this is good, this is better, and this is bad, this is worse. You have knowledge. It's not for anyone. Because how, as I said, how to know this is haram or this major sin, this minor sin? When you have knowledge. And so this is the issue I'm repeating again and again for the da'wah people. You need knowledge. This is very important. You need knowledge, because you know, sometimes the issue, when you speak like this, it's okay. I'm speaking and you are listening, writing or whatever. Khalas. But when you go to the practical life, someone is telling you a big issue. So sometimes you find the scholar telling this person, you do this. Sheikh, this is haram. Because if this person doesn't do this haram, he will do something worse. طيب, so back to the point. أنهم يبدأون دعوتهم بأن بدأ الله به ورسوله. What did the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم start with? You start with the same thing. So again, you need to know, you need the knowledge from the seerah of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. ويؤخرون ما أخره الله ورسوله. By that, يمكن تحسين المصالح ودرء المفاسد. So by this way, then you can get more مصلحة, more benefit, and you avoid more bad things. This is the wisdom. The narration of Aisha, it is long hadith Bukhari, Bukhari. It is long hadith, but let's take this part. إنما نزل أول ما نزل. Aisha was telling one of the tabi'een. إنما نزل أول ما نزل. Yes. Okay, it is here in English. Aisha said, oh, they are being informed that the first thing that was revealed thereof was a surah from Al-Mufassal. And in it was mentioned paradise and the fire. Paradise and fire, this is fiqh or aqeedah? Aqeedah. Aqeedah, the pillars of faith. تؤمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله واليوم الآخر. To believe in the last day. And part of the last day, paradise and hellfire. So, aqeedah. Okay, what is the meaning of mufassal? Mufassal, from Surah Qaf until the end of the Quran. Or from Surah Hujurat until the end of the Quran. Most of these surah, Makki or Madani? Makki. Makki surah talk about rules or about the hereafter? Hereafter and stories of the prophets. So, aqeedah. And it... And it was mentioned paradise and fire. When the people embraced Islam, the verses regarding legal and illegal things were revealed, which means fiqh, which means sharia. If the first thing, then Aisha said, radiallahu anha, if the first thing to be revealed was don't drink khamr, people would have said, we will never leave khamr. And if there had been revealed, don't commit illegal sexual intercourse, they would have said, we will never give up illegal sexual intercourse, zina. While I was a young girl of playing age, the following verse was revealed in Makkah to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, بَلِ السَّاعَةُ مَوْعِدُهُمْ وَالسَّاعَةُ أَدْهَا وَأَمَرُ. Nay, but the hour is their appointed time for their full recompense, and the hour will be more grievous and more bitter. So this is very important narration in Bukhari, which is to prepare the aqidah. And this is one of the main issues, brothers, sisters. Many times I mentioned this. When you check now, in Kuwait, I'm not saying a non-Muslim country, in Kuwait, Muslim country, and Kuwaitis, because we study in our schools, from grade 1 up to grade 12, it is clear, zina is haram, khamr is haram, riba is haram. صح? This is clear in our schools. Every week we study two or three times Islam class. And the Jum'ah khutbah, many Jum'ah khutbah about riba. صح? When you check people, with people, the Kuwaiti, Assalamu alaikum, do you know riba? Yes. Haram or halal? Haram. Then go to the riba bank. Is it empty? Many people. Shlon, how? You ask all of them, riba halal or haram? They say riba haram. And it is a major sin. And we studied this from the school, and the Jum'ah khutbah, the imam, and on TV. All people know that practicing, non-practice. What is the point? The point, the aqidah. The level of faith. Muslims are not prepared. Many Muslims, or most of Muslims. This is the statement of Aisha. Because people are not prepared, so you tell them, this is haram, this is wajib. And we are not using this knowledge. Why? Because the aqidah is not well prepared. The heart is not well prepared. But imagine, when you prepare people, be careful. If you disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you'll be in the hellfire, Allah will punish you. When you obey Allah, you will be in paradise. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will support you. And you emphasize the issue of aqidah, the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then, after 1, 2, 3, 4 years, okay, you tell people and you then you teach the rules of haram and halal. It will be easy for them to accept. Of course, this doesn't mean that يعني, now I don't teach my children what is haram and halal until the age of 15 or 16. No, I tell them, of course. I tell my son, my daughter from the age of 5, 6, don't lie. Of course, lying is haram. But what is the point here? The point here is the importance of aqidah. And here specifically, the issue of the hereafter. من كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فليقل خيرا أو ليصمت. The one who believes in Allah on the last day, he should say good or keep silent. What is the relationship? The beginning of the hadith, aqidah. The second part of the hadith, manners of the tongue. What is the relationship? Yes. Because if you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the last day, you remember the hellfire, you fear the hellfire, خلاص, you will control your tongue. شوف the connection. We need to learn that way from the Quran and Sunnah. How to connect the aqidah in a proper way with our acts. The issue here, when you pray, Allah loves you. When you fast, Allah loves you. When you give charity, Allah loves you. And you emphasize this concept, love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب, and you know, for the kids, priority for the love. You show them, you tell them about the love of Allah. يعني, you know, a kid, يعني, what is the problem? Sometimes you notice the parents, The child maybe 4 years old fire. If you lie, you'll be in the hellfire. Allah will throw you in the hellfire. Habibi, he doesn't know the hellfire. He's 4 years old. But you can't tell him, he can't, this is not good. But with age, inshallah, he can understand. But you tell a kid 4, 5, 6 years old, you'll be in the hellfire? Or yani, you'll have 70 of the hur'een when you be a shaheed? He doesn't know. He will not realize that. طيب. Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah, rahimahullah, mentioned in the ayah, وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا مُوسَى الْكِتَابِ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا أَهْلَكْنَا الْقُرُونَ الْأُولَى مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا أَهْلَكْنَا الْقُرُونَ الْأُولَى. We gave Musa the book, عليه الصلاة والسلام, after we destroyed the previous centuries. He said, Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah, rahimahullah, لما أهلك الله فرعون وقومه واستقرت دعوة موسى عليه الصلاة والسلام أنزل الله عليه الكتاب الذي هو التوراة. When Allah سبحانه وتعالى destroyed فرعون and his people, and Allah سبحانه وتعالى made the دعوة of موسى stable, Allah revealed the book to him, which is the Torah. Again, ولقد آتينا موسى الكتاب, we gave موسى the book, which means which book? التوراة. He said, من بعد after destroying فرعون. طيب. So this is a very nice point from Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah rahimahullah. Okay, the book, the rules came after the destruction of فرعون. طيب. Number 7. Number 7. أنهم يعظمون جميع أمور الدين. The Salaf respect all issues in the religion. فيدعون إلى ما دعا إليه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قدر استطاعة. They call people to it as much as possible. All aspects, all the issues in religion, the Salaf respect all of them. The beard, the siwak, the thawb above the ankle, fasting Monday, Thursday, moving the finger in the salah, how to all the issues. Why? Why you mention this point? Because the issue of dividing religion into qushur walub, envelope and core. This is dangerous. And also Sheikh Fawzan said, maybe this word can lead to kufr wal-iyadu billah. The person will be, maybe he will be a kafir if he is not ignorant. Okay, what do you mean this is qushur? Qushur, the envelope. Okay, I'm eating the orange. I remove the envelope and I throw it. So you mean the beard is envelope, يعني, we don't care? This is like garbage or astaghfirullah. This is haram. And the famous ayah here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا ادْخُلُوا فِي السِّلْمِ كَافَّةً. This is a very important ayah. All you have believed, enter into Islam completely. Ibn Kathir, رحمه الله تعالى, said, يَقُولُ اللَّهُ آمِرًا عِبَادُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ الْمُصَدِّقِينَ بِرَسُولِهِ أَنْ يَأْخُذُوا بِجَمِيعِ عُرَى الْإِسْلَامِ وَشَرَائِعِهِ وَالْعَمَلِ بِجَمِيعِ أَوَامِرِهِ وَتَرْكِ جَمِيعِ زَوَاجِرِهِ. Ibn Kathir, رحمه الله, mentioned the ayah here means to take all the issues of Islam, the rules, the rules of Islam, and to act upon all of them, and to leave al-zawajir, the prohibitions, as much as you can. Then he mentioned, قال مجاهد بن كثير, said مجاهد, one of the scholars of tafsir. وقال مجاهد, the ayah means اعملوا بجميع الأعمال ووجوه البر. Do all the deeds and the good things. يا أيها الذين آمنوا ادخلوا في السلم. السلم here means Islam. السلم means peace. But here it means Islam. ادخلوا في السلم كافة. All of it. So Islam is not a buffet. I take what I like, I leave what I don't like. You have to like all the rules of Islam. You have to. You have to. And this is a very important point. And he gave here examples in the Salah. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Jama'ah Salah. He said, حديث البخاري مسلم, عباد الله لتسوون صفوفكم أو ليخالفن الله بين قلوبكم. All slaves of Allah, if you don't straighten your lines, Allah will make the difference among your hearts. Nowadays, what is the issue of foot to foot in the salah? Many Muslims don't care. I touch my friend or my foot little bit in front, back, people don't care. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam connected this small issue that we think it is very small issue with what? With the animosity and hatred among the hearts. So this is one of the reasons why the Muslims don't unite. Sheikh, is it possible? For unity we need the meetings, and Habibi, before the meetings, we need in the Salah. Before uniting the countries, unite the people of your masjid. Now we are fighting in one masjid, we are fighting. In one masjid there are 20, 40 people fighting. And you want to unite the whole Muslim ummah? Different languages, different madahib, different fiqh. Start from your masjid. Start from your home. How many issues you are fighting with your wife? Niqab wajib, niqab not wajib. This is mustahab, this is haram, this, صح? How many times? And every time you are the loser, صح? Losers? No, you should be a man. Full of the haqq. طيب. طيب. So this is a very important point. Also, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, ما حسدتكم اليهود على شيء ما حسدتكم على السلام والتأمين. Jews, يعني سبحان الله, this is one of the significant point of Jews, which is الحسد, envy, أعوذ بالله. So they have the envy in many issues, but the main thing they are making the envy to the Muslims, two things: السلام والتأمين, saying Ameen the Salah and giving Salam. Subhanallah. So look, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, you know, one of the main enemies of Muslims, Jews. He did not mention an issue, like a major issue that people think, but he mentioned these two points. Subhanallah. As-salam wa ta'ameen, saying Ameen the Salah. Many Muslims don't care about Ameen in the Salah. Another narration, this is very important hadith, very important hadith. An al-Azraq ibn Qais, ibn Qais, he said, one imam prayed for us. His name is Abu Rimtha. Abu Rimtha said, I prayed this prayer with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, which means he is a sahabi, he is a companion. Abu Bakr and Umar were there praying in the first line on the right side of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and there was a man joined the salah from takbirat al-ihram, which means he did not miss any rak'ah. From the beginning he was with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam finished the salah, he gave the salam, salam alaykum rahmatullah, salam alaykum rahmatullah. We saw someone stood up starting takbirat ihram. So one man immediately after the salah, during the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, one man stood up, Allahu Akbar, praying the sunnah. He did not say astaghfirullah, no adhkar, nothing, nothing. In his place, he stood up, Allahu Akbar. Umar radiallahu ta'ala immediately jumped on that man. And yani, he pushed his, or he shaked his shoulder. He said, sit down. The Prophet was there, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Umar said, sit down. Ijlis. Why? فإنه لم يهلك أهل الكتاب إلا أنهم لم يكن بين صلوات فصل. Sit down. The thing which destroyed the people of the book, that there is no break between the fard and the nafil. Subhanallah. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam looked up and he said, "Asab Allah bika ibn al-Khattab." You said the truth, oh Ibn al-Khattab. Maybe some people, okay, what is the issue? Why you are making this a big issue? Alhamdulillah, I pray the fard, I'm doing the sunnah. No, you have to make a break. The other hadith, حتى يتكلم أو ينصرف. Change your place or you go home, you pray the sunnah, or say the adhkar, for example, or you speak. Okay, after giving the salam, you say the adhkar, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. You say adhkar, then you pray sunnah, okay. Or for example, assalamu alaikum, how are you? You speak to your friend, then you pray sunnah. But after the salam immediately, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, Allahu Akbar. No. Because of this way, Allah destroyed the people of the book. Destruction. This is the, subhanAllah, a very important issue. Wallahi, people, subhanAllah, don't care. And again, I'm repeating this many times. People, subhanAllah, strange. People celebrating 7th of October. Celebrating what? Gaza. Are you celebrating because more than 40,000 innocent people killed? What kind of celebration? No, we should show the happiness. Shouldn't happen. Which happiness? You killed 1,000 or 2,000 of Jews. On the other hand, more than 40,000 innocent Muslims killed, and how many millions lost their wealth and houses? Subhanallah. Then they speak about boycott. Boycott Starbucks and McDonald's. Habibi, speak about the Quran and Sunnah. Look now, Starbucks, they lost this much of billions. Look, boycotting. Okay, they lost. But what benefit you achieve for the Muslims in Palestine? Or the generally the Muslim Ummah? This is the problem. Who are leading? Sometimes you'll find ignorant people. Ignorant people. Habibi, you are speaking about Palestine. What kind of... And subhanAllah, you'll find these people criticizing our scholars, our shuyukh. يعني they criticize, for example, Sheikh Salih Fawzan. Habibi, Sheikh Salih Fawzan, one of the scholars, he studied Sharia, bachelor, master, PhD. He is at the committee giving fatwa for years before the birth of your father. Then he's criticizing him. What is your degree? Doctor. What is your degree? Fashionista. شنو هذا؟ والله strange. And they are not speaking from the Quran and Sunnah. Do you think that, do you notice these people speak about this point? Because we want to unite the Muslim Ummah. How to unite the Muslim Ummah? You should know what is mentioned in the Quran and Sunnah. And subhanAllah, one of them said, well, this was a plant. 41 or more than 40,000 Muslims killed. This is a plant. Astaghfirullah al-Azim. And you are outside. They don't care about the blood of the Muslims. They don't care. He is sitting in this country or that country, speak about the innocent people. They are shaheed. Okay, why you are not shaheed? Go to be shaheed with them. What kind of shahada this? Subhanallah, speak about, you're very easy. Shaheed, shaheed, shaheed. And you remember 2011, and okay, let them 1 million to die. Habibi, wallahi, when you hit a cat, you cannot sleep at night. When you hit a cat by mistake with the car, you cannot sleep. 1 million saying that. And when I remember one of them, famous video. He said, oh, no problem with the Syrian people. They are easy. They can multiply a lot. They get many children. Subhanallah. Shumana. When 100,000, 1 million killed, no problem, they can't bring more children. What kind of mentality this? Subhanallah. So we need like these ahadith, brothers, sisters, to circulate like this ahadith among the Muslims, to realize the importance of sunnah. People think these are small issues. No, they are big issues. Look, Umar Khattab said the thing which destroyed the Yahud, okay, or يعني people of the book, this issue. Because you pray the sunnah immediately after the fard. Imagine, brothers and sisters, imagine now if you give a Jum'ah khutbah, okay, maybe I do this for the Jum'ah khutbah, coming Jum'ah khutbah, okay, how to support Palestine, and you mentioned this hadith. The people they want, the Arab rulers, the Muslim rulers, they should unite, they should send army to Palestine. Habibi, for that, yes, no doubt, the army is important, jihad is important, but also don't ignore this hadith. عجيب والله. Look, Salman رضي الله تعالى, Salman Farisi, one of the kuffar criticized him, and he criticized the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم saying, what is this your Prophet teaching you that? How do you go to the toilet and you... He said, yes. Salman did not feel shy. Salman رضي الله did not, Salman Farisi, did not feel shy. He said, yes. He said, the Prophet ﷺ told us to use, not to use this than three stones and to do this. It is not a shame. It is not a shame. So don't feel shame from your religion. Subhanallah. Dinner ready? Okay. Sheikh Fawzan here, Hafidhullah said, this principle clarifies that, which means, it doesn't mean that when we say we start with Tawheed and we focus on Tawheed, this doesn't mean we ignore the other issues. And we mentioned that we start with Tawheed, we focus on, but this doesn't mean to ignore the other issues. Okay, so the Salafi people don't speak only about Tawheed, they speak about the whole religion. As we mentioned, the ayah يدخل في السلم كافة. But where is the focus? On the Tawheed. And also when we say to focus Tawheed, this doesn't mean if I am Muhid, okay, I know the Aqidah Wasitiyah, Aqidah Tahawiyah, this doesn't mean that you do the sins. No. You should avoid major and minor sins. And also you have to pray, you give zakat, you treat your parents in a nice way, your wife, your husband. You have to. So this is a very important point, which is the impact, the bad impact of sins. So this is one of the ways to unite the Muslim Ummah, avoid all the sins. جزاكم الله خيرا. وصلى الله وسلم على محمد.
There is a question.
Yes, yes.
Sheikh mentioned Baqarah ayat 13 in previous lecture. Can you explain again? Surah Baqarah ayat 13.
Surah Baqarah ayah? What is the ayah? I mentioned this ayah?
Last verse.
وإذا قيل لهم آمنوا سورة البقرة آية نمبر 13 وإذا قيل لهم آمنوا كما آمن الناس قالوا أنؤمن كما آمن السفهاء ألا إنهم سفهاء ولكن لا يعلمون. And when it is said to them, believe as the people have believed. Okay, so here the word people means the Sahaba, the companions رضي الله تعالى عنهم. They say, should we believe as the foolish have believed? So they accuse the Sahaba as foolish. It is they who are the foolish, but they know it not. Okay, maybe they mean that the word "nas." Okay, it has several meanings. Yes, "nas" means people, but sometimes it means specific kind of people. Surah Ali Imran: "الذين قال لهم الناس إن الناس قد جمعوا لكم فخشواهم فزادهم إيمانا." الذين قال لهم الناس طيب هذه سورة آل عمران قال لهم Surah Ali Imran, ayah number 173. Those to whom people said, indeed the people have gathered against you. Innas, innas, people, people. Okay, what does it mean? Those to whom people, here means hypocrites. الَّذِينَ قَالَ لَهُمُ النَّاسِ said, indeed the people here means the kuffar, kuffar of Quraysh, disbelievers of Quraysh. So it is the same word. But how can I, which is which? The context. And the tafsir, asbab al-nuzul, the sunnah. To know the meaning of the ayah. Okay?
Sir.
Yes, sir. Which surah? Which number four? We don't understand the Quran and the Sunnah independently from the understanding of the Salaf. Yes. Okay. Anything? جزاكم الله خيرا وصلي الله وسلم على نبينا محمد.